Hi, I'm Bill Bradley with Digital Guardian, here to talk about protecting what matters most to your organization, the data. To protect your data, you need to understand your data. And to understand your data, you need to know where all of it is. Data discovery and data classification are two closely linked initiatives that both Forrester and Gartner are calling foundational to an effective data security strategy. I'll start with discovery. You need to find all the data, especially regulated or sensitive data, whether it lives on endpoints such as laptops and desktops, servers, in databases, file shares, or as increasingly the case in the cloud. Data discovery is a crucial component of compliance readiness, but also locates where IP is stored in the enterprise. Considering the connectivity that exists today between business processes, data is placed in several systems, applications, databases, and shared files, making its protection, authentication, and confidentiality a challenge for enterprises. Discovery should be viewed as an ongoing business process. New data is constantly being created, modified, and stored. Organizations must keep track of this evolution of their data. With the discovery process underway, next comes classification to better understand that data. The understanding is what drives security strategy. Organizations can classify their data via several methods. I'll outline the top three: context, content, and user. Contextual classification relies on attributes about the document that can be used to assess its sensitivity. Engineering servers or finance servers, for example, contain information that should be kept internal. Anything placed on these servers is given heightened protection. Contextual factors can also include the data creator and application used. There are hundreds of contextual factors. Classifying via content requires analysis and interpretation of the data to decide where it falls into predetermined categories. Within content-based classification are multiple techniques. Each can be used individually or combined for a hybrid approach. These include fingerprinting and regular expression. Finally, user-based classification. It is on one hand the simplest, but also the most complex for the same reason. It is user-driven and dependent. At the creation of a document or upon editing, the user designates which of the predefined categories it belongs to. Because it is a manual process, the user must remember to perform the task, then consistently apply a policy. As they are the closest to the data, user-based decisions can deliver superior accuracy over automated approaches. The last point to consider regarding classifications is how many categories to have. Here, more is not always better. We recommend starting off with just three: restricted for regulated information such as financial or patient data, internal for employee-facing materials, and external for anything public-facing. Like discovery, classification needs to be an evolving process. Over time, data can move among these categories. A year-end press release can go from restricted to internal to public in a matter of days. The analyst community agrees, discovery and classification are two interrelated foundational elements. Finding the data and then classifying it will drive a more accurate overall security program. Please visit digitalguardian.com for more information about our industry-leading data discovery, classification, and protection solutions.